reading from the book of Luke. Then he went to the Mount of Olives, and the disciples followed him. When he arrived, he said to them, "Pray that you may not undergo the test." After withdrawing about a stone's throw from them and kneeling, he prayed, saying, "Father, if you are willing, take this cup away from me, still not my will, but yours be done." And to strengthen him, an angel from heaven appeared to him. He was in such agony, and he prayed so fervently that his sweat became like drops of blood falling on the ground. When he rose from prayer and returned to his disciples, he found them sleeping. He said to them, "Why are you sleeping? Get up and pray that you may not undergo the test." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Lord Jesus, for the love of us, you suffer. Your life for us, you offer. Grant us your salvation. As we go through the season of Lent, may we journey with you, saying yes to the Father's will every day, in every way. No matter what the cost it means saving the lost. Our sinful humanity in need of your grace and mercy. Thank you, Jesus, through your life and love, save our ship, tossed by the storms of this earth. We need you through your suffering, death, and resurrection, save our souls. May we live holy and thus be truly happy. And lead us to heaven forever with you. Amen.
Shalom, dear brothers and sisters in Christ. I am Seminarian Davy from St. Peter's College of Kuching. And today, I would like to share with you a reflection on the Lord's agony in the garden. I believe many of us are familiar with the account of the Lord's agony in the garden. Most common would be to know that it is the first sorrowful mystery of the rosary. Some might have seen it as a painting, or some might have known it as one of the scenes in a movie regarding the Lord's passion. A beautiful part of this account is that it took place in a garden. How would you picture a garden? Well, some would describe it as a peaceful place filled with trees and flowers, or insects and animals. We could also encounter people strolling along with their loved ones. It is truly a place where we encounter. In the Bible, there are a few significant events that took place in the garden. Firstly, as we have mentioned earlier, and on which we are reflecting today, there is Christ's agony in the garden called Gethsemane. The other significant event that happened in the garden can be found as well in the earliest part of the Bible, the book of Genesis. Yes, the Garden of Eden. It was in Eden that mankind encountered God and had that pure, beautiful relationship. But the tragic part of this beautiful creation story is that mankind committed sin. Because of sin, mankind was sent away from their glorious state as punishment and to experience suffering, sickness, and death. Although mankind has to bear these consequences, God, in His love and mercy, never abandoned them, but made a promise that salvation is sure. What was once closed due to man's disobedience, now through Christ, has been made available. Eternal life is made possible through Jesus, the promised Messiah. But Jesus has to bear the consequence to win over the power of darkness in order to earn back our dignity as children of God. He was to suffer grievously for our sin. Jesus Christ has to undergo agony for our salvation, an agony that I believe he did not only experience at the garden, but all the way during his earthly ministry, as depicted in the Gospels. Could we recall them? That pure human experience of Jesus' agony. What would have been his feeling when he knows his own cousin John the Baptist was persecuted, or when Martha cried to him regarding the death of Lazarus, or when the blind, the lame, and the lepers came to him seeking for healing? There is nothing pleasurable in the idea of having to suffer agony. If it is possible, anyone would have preferred avoiding dealing with it. But agony is part of real human experiences. Jesus too is not spared from dealing with it, since he came to be with us, to be like us. One can always inquire, how did he manage to go through his agony in the garden? If he was dealing with it supernaturally, then his whole experience of the passion is meaningless and non-relatable to us. Not though that his experience of agony in the garden was so immense that the Gospel's accounts depict him sweating blood, and he had the angels to care for him after that. His suffering was very real, and thus it served its purpose. It is so that we are able to see that there is another side in suffering. Year 2021 could be another garden experience for many of us, and it may differ with each person. Since the beginning of 2020, the outbreak of COVID-19 has changed the diverse normal pattern in life, especially in its social and economic aspects. I believe most of us are affected in one way or another. For me, this year has affected me so much not because of COVID, but rather that I have experienced, firstly, the loss of a loved one during the period I was, secondly, doing my pastoral immersion after I left home about 2 weeks later. During that bereavement period, I was struggling internally because of the many worries that I had in my mind. My beloved grandmother was baptized late in her age, and we were the only Catholic family in that area. My family and I never dealt with funeral arrangements, and my concern was to ensure a proper Christian burial for her. Somehow, I am thankful to God for, at such difficult moment, he provided by sending angels to help our family. During that time, Catechist Grace was constantly in touch to give me preliminary guidance to arrange and lead wake prayers before the funeral. Priests offered to remember her during the Mass, and some even came to visit along with the catechist and her companions. Our family members, although from different Christian denominations, came together to help and support each other, as well as the surrounding kampong community. After then, it was even harder to return back to my pastoral immersion program, where I needed to learn to regulate my emotions. I remember that I could barely hold back my tears when I went to visit a parishioner's house who also just lost his youngest son from an accident. At that moment, I too relate on how the mourning family must have felt. I did not regret turning up because I know my presence and that of others meant something for the family. Yes, Agony could at times make us lose ourselves and even our faith, even to the point of doubting God or completely rejecting Him. But Jesus in His agony showed what faith is all about. Let go and let God. There are situations in life when we will never understand how things come to happen and why. But in order to continue living life as God wants, we must allow Him to take control of things that are sometimes beyond our understanding. We may do the best we could, but at the same time, we must leave the rest to God. He surely works things according to His own way and time. In life, suffering and faith, St. Paul has this to say: do not lose heart, even though our outer nature is wasting away. Our inner nature is renewed day by day. For this slight momentary affliction is preparing us for an eternal weight of glory beyond all measure. In the moments of agony, the love of the Father reaches out. He embraced His Son to give Him the strength and courage He needed to accomplish His mission. In the same spirit, all we need to do is to surrender and trust in the Father's sure and loving care for us in whatever plan He has for us in the future. It may be another garden for us to stroll along, but one thing is for sure: He will never abandon us. In the garden of our lives, let us encounter God always.
So right now, what I'm currently struggling most with would be not being able to attend physical masses, and especially daily masses, because I used to attend daily masses with my parents. And not being able to receive the Eucharist physically, it somewhat gives me a different feeling, and sometimes I feel a little incomplete. And one more thing would be not being able to attend youth gatherings, because we usually have youth gatherings every Friday nights, and now that youth gatherings have been suspended and all our physical activities like camps, Easter rally and all these, it somewhat makes me feel really different, and not having this sense of community in a way that we connect physically and having human interaction, although we do have like virtual youth gatherings and all those. But sometimes it do feel a little different, and sometimes it gets a little lonely not being able to, you know, have fellowship with friends and whatnot. And I think I can speak up for a lot of students that sometimes online studies is a little bit of a struggle for some of us as well. And I really hope that the pandemic would get better so that like we can go back to normal again. Personally, I believe that God sends His angels to strengthen us in various ways. And for me, I find it in the little things that happen to me in my daily life. For example, it could be just a simple text message or a phone call from a friend asking me how my day went. It could be a random act of kindness or a word of affirmation or even just a smile. You know, these things gives me strength to know that there are always people here for me and being by my side. And these are the things that actually warm my heart.
Thank you. brothers and sisters, thank you very much for choosing to be one with us in this Lenten prayer reflection that we are having. SOS, Christ's suffering is an offering for our salvation. I hope this and the rest of the videos to follow will really help us get into the spirit of the season, to appreciate more and more how much God loves us, that He has suffered for us, for our salvation. On this first episode, through the prayer, the singing, the sharing, we have met Jesus, who is there agonizing in the garden. This reminds me of the many people who are also in pain, probably you and I included. And Jesus, our loving, saving God, is with us, suffering with us, suffering for us. The agony in the garden of Jesus in Gethsemane reminds me of the traffic light. Next time you find yourself stuck in traffic and you see that red, yellow, and green, remember this. Red means stop. If you feel you are the reason for somebody to be in pain, if you honestly feel you're the cause for someone to be in agony, please stop. Enough. Show kindness instead. Let us not be reasons for others' pain. And if you feel you know someone who is in agony, then yellow, stay. Stay with that someone. He needs you more than ever. May you be that angel who is God's instrument for that somebody to feel God's strength, God's inspiration, God's direction. If you know someone in agony, yellow, stay. Stay with him. Be God's angel to him. And if you feel you are that someone who is agonizing, who is experiencing a painful situation in your life, then green, go. Go with God. Go. Follow the Father's will, even if it means you will be scourged on the pillar, crowned with thorns. You will be carrying a cross which probably might not be even yours. Go with God. Go follow the Father's will, even if it will lead you to being nailed on the cross, being crucified, being killed. Just like Jesus, go follow the Father's will. In God's grace and time, all your pain will go away. And God won't. God's love, God's grace, God's salvation. God in your life is here to stay. The Lord be with you. And may the Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. May Christ and our suffering be an offering for ours and others' salvation.
soar with